your little one is having teething pains and you are looking for a perfect teether for your baby, this video will help you find the best and most suitable teether for your baby as per your baby's age. Towards the end, I will also share some tips and tricks for teether and teething. So do watch till the end. Hi guys, this is Nimisha and you're most welcome to my channel. I'm a mom of a 2-year-old and I make honest pregnancy, motherhood and parenting related videos. If you find my content helpful, please do consider subscribing. Let's get straight into the topic. Over the last 2 years, we have gone through so many teethers and we bought them after quite a bit of research. So I thought it would be a great idea to share with you guys our reviews and recommendations. Teething is not a milestone. Some babies are even born with teeth. Most of the babies get it around 6 months of age and some even get it after their first birthdays. As long as the babies are feeding well, which means they're getting sufficient calcium and also prescribed vitamin D supplements, there is generally nothing to worry about. The timing of teething is mostly genetic. First teeth is really painful for the babies and then the molars again trouble them a lot. Teethers greatly help in soothing their gums during these times. Let's start with teethers for 0 to 4 months old babies. Now, my baby started teething quite early at around 2 months and I found it so difficult at the time because he could barely hold on to any teether. His mouth was way too small and I thought most of the teethers were quite harsh for his delicate gums. Maybe that's why most of the teethers are prescribed for babies aged 4 months and above. Our doctor prescribed that we massage his gums using our fingers and I found that to be the best way because we could easily regulate the pressure using our fingers. During the massage, since babies would be suckling and gulping, we made sure that the nails were properly trimmed and our fingers were absolutely clean. So between 4 to 6 months, we love this Komotomo teether the most. This is made of silicone and it has 4 tiny extensions. It is quite soft and the arms are little firm and they have little grids on them. You could just put it on babies like bangles and they can chew away on it. The arms fit into their mouth perfectly well and these are so gentle on their gums. Once my baby turned 6 months old, we absolutely loved these Loopy teethers. We liked them so much that we got 2 of these. These are again made of silicone, they are quite soft and gummy and their bristles have slightly more traction than the Komotomo one. Now the packet does say that these are for 3 months plus babies, but I thought these were a little big for their tiny mouths. So once my baby grew older, he found much better use for this. We also really like this baby banana teether. These are quite popular and I think they are quite bright and cute. My 6 months old baby could easily hold onto them. The head is quite thin, so it could easily go inside my baby's mouth. And they basically work like finger brush. So these are pretty damn good. But the only thing that I would like to say about these are that when I went to buy this, I saw that there were so many sellers selling this and then there were reviewers saying that the bristles were breaking, which was quite scary to me. So I just made sure that I was getting it from the genuine company and that the reviews were good for this because I did not want to be in that predicament. Finger brushes are great as well. Their purpose is to help you brush your baby the moment they sprout their first tooth. But they work great as teethers as well. So I would just put them on my finger and move it around baby's mouth. Sometimes my baby would bite me and it helped me understand where exactly he was feeling the pain. And also I could control the pressure pretty well with it. I would also mention 3 more teethers because they're so popular. And we did use 2 out of those 3. So the first one is Sofila Giraffe. These guys do make couple of more designs. This is the most popular teether you'll find. And also the first teether that we bought for our baby when he was 2 months old. Now the packet does say that it is for 0 plus months old babies. But we did learn our lesson the hard way. This teether has plenty of surfaces to bite and it has pretty good grips. But the teether in itself is quite hard for such young babies. We did try to reintroduce it to our baby recently when he was sprouting molars and he was old enough to tell us when and which teether he actually wanted. He still never quite preferred this one. He always went for Loopy or the banana teether. But then at the end of the day, it does depend on your baby's preference. The next teether is called Munchkin Mitts. Now these are so popular and I honestly had so much hopes from them when I bought them. But I did not find them to be quite economic. The concept is so good that you can just put it on your baby's hands like mittens and they can chew away on it and these would not even disappear anywhere. The designs are so cute and it also crinkles. So overall it seemed very good to me. However, I did not find it ergonomic at all. For starters, these are a tad bit heavy and also quite big for little baby's mouth. The packet says that it is for baby under 1 year. Babies drool a lot when they are teething and this material would get wet so soon. I used to hand wash it and this would not dry as soon as I would have liked it to because the material is quite thick and also there are stuff like Velcro on it. I felt like I needed to have multiple quantities of it so that I could have one dry and ready. As my baby grew older, he did not like having it on his hands and he couldn't manage to wriggle his hands out of it and just throw it away. So in all, I never really got much use out of this. The final teether that I would like to mention are these breast milk teething pops. You get these tiny little molds for ice lollies and you can put pumped breast milk into it and freeze them. And when the kid wants it, you can just hand them over the breast milk ice lollies and they can suckle onto it. So while it will soothe the baby's gums, at the same time baby will be suckling onto breast milk which will fill their tummies. So talk about two birds. The only issue that I found with it was that there are some studies which say that while cold teethers are okay, putting ice directly onto baby's gums might harm them in long run. So I'm not a doctor and I cannot confirm authenticity of these reports, but I thought it was worth mentioning in case you were considering it so that you make an informed decision while buying them. Coming to the tips. Tip number one. Cold teethers are way more soothing, so keeping them in fridge before baby uses them will help them work more efficiently and soothe your baby's gum more effectively. Tip number 2. Teething babies drool a lot and that can result into a nasty rash around their mouth. You can see them as red dots. So you can totally prevent them by keeping the mouth dry, by dabbing them clean frequently and also using cream. I personally used the nipple butter because it was edible and it also had calendula. Tip number 3. Bandana bibs or any cloth bibs can be very handy since you can just tie them around your baby's neck and you can use them to keep their mouths dry. Tip number 4. Since babies are constantly chewing on teethers, I found it very important to sterilize them at least once a day, especially when the babies are very small because babies chew on them constantly. Tip number 5. It is always worth checking the material of teether before getting them. We got gifted a lot of cute looking teethers, however they were made of cheap plastic and bad quality rubber which could not be sterilized. Also, we have to make sure that there are no loose parts on the teether which can go in the baby's mouth. Tip number 6. While cold carrots and cucumber make great teether, these cannot be introduced to very small babies who cannot sit up on their own without supervision because these are choking hazards. They make great teethers but only for older toddlers. Tip number 7. Some people use honey for teething infants, but one should never use honey for baby under 1 year old because it can cause infant botulism which can be fatal. Number 8. One great tip in toddlers is that you can use a very soft elastic string and put teethers on it and tie it around their neck and they can chew on it whenever they want to and then they won't be throwing away the teethers very often. They would remain clean and would be available for them whenever they want to use it. This needs to be done under supervision or it can be a choking hazard. I hope the video was helpful to you and if you like the video then please consider liking the video and subscribing to my channel. I will see you in my next video. Bye!